What's up, everybody? It's your boy Tone, one half of the best black movie review podcast in the world. In the world, Craig. This episode of the Blackbusters podcast is brought to you by Amazon Prime. Prime is more than just free shipping. Prime brings you closer to the things you care about today through shopping, streaming, and savings. For example, did you know that you can listen to your favorite podcasts, like ours, through Amazon Music? Yup. You can also watch your favorite movies, like the ones we review on Blackbusters, on Amazon Prime Video. Yep. But it doesn't stop there. You can use Prime to get more out of your interests. From purchasing behind-the-scenes books about your favorite movies to listening to soundtracks of your favorite films. Yep, yep, and yep. Whatever you're into, or just getting into, Prime can help you get closer to it. Visit Amazon.com/Prime to sign up. From movies and music to passions and podcasts, it's on Prime.
At State Farm, we're committed to uplifting Black futures. In collaboration with organizations like 100 Black Men and National Urban League, State Farm provides high school students with the opportunity to learn and apply best practice strategies for saving and investing, all while offering academic support, life skills, and exposure to college access programs to prepare these students for life after high school. Check out 100blackmen.org and nul.org to donate and learn more. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're now listening to the CareFree Black Girl Podcast, where we discuss everything carefree, black, and
girl.
Hold up.
What's up, y'all? It's Nika. We are back for another season, a new year. Like, okay, we here. We made it 2022. I'm excited. Honestly, I've just been kicking off the new year. I mean, we had a show at the top of the year for Broke to Dope. It was fun. It was great. Cool. Just experience. And now just getting ready for South By. That's kind of my focus right now.
Yes.
What's up, Candy? What about you?
Hey, y'all. It is DJ Candy Raine, whatever you like to call me. Yes, it is a new year, new season. I honestly am been playing it real low key. If you've been listening to the past episodes, I was a little burnt out and tired.
Yes.
So for me, you know, I'm all about balance this year, and I've been trying to do a better job at actually not doing nothing. Mm-hmm. And I have a real bad habit with that. And so far, so good. So I'm hoping as things pick up and I'm ready to get out my shell, I can maintain that balance. But for now, I'm in the cut, kind of low key with it. But, you know, I'm definitely happy to be recording. It's been a little while.
It has been a minute.
And, you know, with that being said, it being a new season, we do have some new talent joining the show, and we're super excited about that. We want to give a shout out to our girl Sydney, who was with us last season. You know, we wish her the best and all is well, and you guys will definitely be seeing her at other events. But we definitely, you know, wanted to just give the opportunity and usher in some new heat, and some new ladies and some new carefree black girls. So
yes.
I am going to totally allow these ladies to introduce themselves, and I'm going to pass it over to the left here and go ahead. Our first new carefree black girl.
Hey, my friends, it is the one and only the lit Southern Belle, Mimi Navu.
Oh. Hey, Mimi.
Hey, coming
what's
in
girl?
Hot.
What's up, boo?
And now, did you say Mimi?
Mimi.
Okay, I just want to make sure you know. Yeah. All right, what's up, Mimi? Hey, girl. We definitely going to get to know you a little bit deeper. And then our next carefree black girl.
Period. Okay. Your favorite multimedia maven, Rebellious Kiana.
Wow.
Big dots.
Listen, yo, they coming in hot.
Period.
I love it. Rebellious. Me and you gonna be friends. I like rebellion. You did.
Rebellious.
So how are you ladies doing? Welcome to the show. Y'all nervous? Good. Don't be nervous.
Not really.
No, I'm not.
I like that. I know.
I'm excited. Like, I'm just excited. Yeah, I'm just like really that. Excited.
I'm very excited for the new year. I feel like I have very good hopes for this year, this semester at Clark Atlanta University.
Okay.
Very, very excited.
Yeah,
you know, I feel like it's just something in the air with this year. Like, something about this year just gives me, like, oh, yeah, the girl's just not ready. Like, the girl's just not ready.
I've been feeling that, too, though.
No, I agree.
Literally.
I agree.
I am crying. I love it. I love it. I love it.
What Issa say is me season.
It's me season. For all of us.
No, dead ass, though. I love that. And I love. Did y'all watch Insecure?
Of course.
Yes, I loved Insecure.
How did y'all feel about the ending?
The last season.
I just glad that she was finally secure. Cause I like the scene where she looked into the mirror and there was no little like person in her head that popped up. She just looked, gave the thumbs up and walked away. She'd even keep standing in that mirror.
You know what? I think that's a great point. I don't think anyone kind of has given that perspective. I love
Cause she's
that.
Always talking to herself in that damn mirror. Like, girl, just do it.
Not too much on my sister. Not too
no, but I'm saying, like, sometimes she overthought a lot of things and just self-sabotage. Let's just be honest. She put herself in some of them positions.
And we do that sometimes. I love her, though. Yes, and we gotta love her through it, but you're absolutely right. But that's a definitely good perspective. How about you?
I love Insecure. That's my favorite show. Like, I was so sad. Like, I literally, the season finale dropped, and I didn't watch it until 3 weeks later. Like, I wasn't ready. Me and Closure just don't get along. so I was like, like, I don't even care. I would see people on the timeline talking about it, and I just, not doing that today. Like,
Did you mute the word Insecure?
I didn't. So I was really not all the way committed to, like, ignoring it. But, like, I finally watched it, and I was just like, I felt really good about it. Like, it was a very, very, very good ending to the chapter of Insecure, and I definitely understand why Insecure needed to end, because, like, you know, shows just be going, like, why is Grey's Anatomy have another season?
Yeah.
We should let her die. Like, no shade. But
Let who die? No, not let somebody die.
Let Grey's Anatomy go.
What character should die?
We're on season 38. Like, how long are we gonna keep
that's how long them soap operas be
running? Yeah, it's like a soap opera.
Yeah, y'all grandma was still watching the soap operas when she was 21. Like,
and that's cute, but I feel like Insecure could not have done that. Like, it would have
got real corny.
Yeah, so I love that she ended on a high note, and then she has rap shit coming out. So I just got a couple of months of sadness, and then she'll be back.
She probably got movie. Oh, Spider Man.
Oh, she's Spider Woman.
Spider Woman.
Spider Woman.
Okay, she got some things coming going.
And she has an 8-figure deal with Warner. So she's coming with the content.
She's coming for her things.
And she got radio, which is like her little music thing too. So she got a lot of different things. My girl from Boston is on T-Mar. She's on that label. So that's definitely dope.
Well, I would like to get to know our new host a little bit better. Can you guys tell me about, you said CAU.
Yes.
What year are y'all? What y'all got going on?
I'm a junior. Not really ready to go, but ready to go. I feel like when I was a freshman, I would always say, like, oh, it's ghetto. But then COVID hit and I was sitting at home depressed. So it just very much gives, like, be very cognizant of my tongue. So I'm not going to say that I'm ready to go.
There you go. I like that. Don't do that.
Very real.
Yes.
But yeah, I'm a junior. I'm super excited for this semester. I'm ready to, like, get into who I am on campus and, like, you know, do more in digital now that I know what I want to do. So, yeah, I'm excited.
Nice.
I am a graduating senior.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Okay.
I still have to get used to saying that when I introduce myself to people. But also, I'm not ready to go only because just, like, the environment, I loved it so much because I came from a very white ass school and the black people that were there, I didn't really get to see them till like high school. So like, I really didn't get to experience like to getting know my culture as a whole at a young age.
Yes,
so it was kind of a lot of culture shock coming into Clark Atlanta. But at the same time, I was used to being around other types of like ethnicities and nationalities and religions and all these walks of life. But my own. The people that did look like me, they didn't like me because I was American. So, like, that was a whole other issue. It was a whole other issue. So, it was really refreshing to come to a place and they look like me and they actually want to get to know me, not because, oh, you're not like the normal black person that I'm used to. And it's like, okay, that's weird. Right. They weren't giving weird energy. Some right. were, but they're not here no more. Mm. So
we love a Panther family.
Yes.
That's part of the reason why I chose to go to like a mainly, you know, black school myself. Mm-hmm. I went to a school in Maryland and I just wanted to be around my people. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? I wanted to soak up that experience. So I think that's interesting, and like look at like even how something like that can bring people together in a different way, right? Like mm-hmm. we're doing a podcast, you know what yeah. I'm saying? And we connected in that way. So I don't know. I just say that to say I think that's dope. Shout out to the HBCU family. Like, yes, you know what I'm saying?
HBCUs in the building.
That's definitely product
of
an
HBCU, okay.
Yeah. Yes. So, yeah, man. And I know navigating through that space through COVID has been tough for y'all. We send y'all love and all our other maybe Please. College listeners too. You know what I'm saying? We know it's been tough. So y'all got this.
Send one up.
Yeah. Y'all got about four of them up. Burn some incense, some sage.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Tone, one half of the best black movie review podcast in the world. In the world, Craig. This episode of the Blackbusters podcast is brought to you by Amazon Prime. Prime is more than just free shipping. Prime brings you closer to the things you care about today through shopping, streaming, and savings. For example, did you know that you can listen to your favorite podcasts, like ours, through Amazon Music? Yup. You can also watch your favorite movies, like the ones we review on Blackbusters, on Amazon Prime Video. Yup. But it doesn't stop there. You can use Prime to get more out of your interests. From purchasing behind-the-scenes books about your favorite movies, to listening to soundtracks of your favorite films. Yup, yup, and yup. Whatever you're into, or just getting into, Prime can help you get closer to it. Visit Amazon.com/Prime to sign up. From movies and music to passions and podcasts, it's on Prime.
College, what's the most risky thing you've done? This is actually a 2.0 episode, you guys, so it's gonna be a little different. We wanna since we got new hosts, we wanna get to know each other. What's the most risky thing you've done?
Oh, mine is I can't tell y'all mine for real. So I'm gonna give y'all the best next version. What y'all got?
Well, y'all know Kiana's gonna come for the heart. My answer is definitely very, very much like sentimental. So the riskiest thing for me that I've ever done in my life is choosing journalism and like media as a career. Because I didn't know there was nobody in my family who did media. Like I come from military background, like that's what I came from. My aunt still be sending me STEM articles, like, girl, what am I gonna do with this? Like, wow, this is not even applicable, hun. You need to just keep this. And so choosing journalism, choosing media, shout out to Scotty Bean, because she was the first person who I really connected with on a media tip.
Wow.
But then also beautiful. Like black women and that passion and really just pouring myself into it, because I fought journalism so bad. Like I took journalism in high school and like I fought it, child. I was like, oh, this is a cute hobby, but like what am I gonna do with my real life? Like,
got it.
But literally toured Clark Atlanta University and was like, yeah,
this is it. Got a feeling and just knew that was it.
Yeah. And I what it really was, I'm gonna be really transparent, I took anatomy in high school. Baby, my senior year, I just wasn't giving. I was like, yeah, no, I cannot do this for the next 4 years. Like,
that's what happened to me.
I could not retain this information. Like, it was definitely giving cell phone under the like that. Yeah, we can't do this forever.
That's what happened to me with computer science. I was gonna go to Spelman to be a computer engineering major. Yeah, why did I say that? I don't know. I was lying.
Then reality hit you when you was like, yeah, no.
I got a C in that class. It was an AP course. Ooh. I was like, yeah, I'm not taking this AP exam. He's like, well, you have to. You already paid for it because it's in the tuition.
Oh, damn.
I was like, I'm not taking this because I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm coding. What are we coding? What is this?
That greatest is risk ever.
Could even love do the it. Homework.
Yeah. Love it here. Love it here.
No, well, definitely love
that's
it
that's
here.
That's a good risk.
I what about think about y'all?
It's going to pay off.
See, I went all nasty. You came all like, I'm like, all right, I guess I can go that route too then, you know.
Nah, what do you got?
Oh,
Miss Mimi.
Oh, gosh. So, I don't even know which story I want to share. I think like I've done a lot of risky stuff now. Don't say that. I ain't do a lot of risky shit. Don't know. I think the riskiest thing I've done, I was with some friends at the time, and we were walking because one of my friends, she's from New York, and I don't know, she just can't sit her ass down. So I'm like, girl, like, it's 3 a.m. Like, what do you want to do? And then she never had no money. So what are we about to do? Nothing. Because you ain't got no money. So, we never went nowhere with her, but like we were just walking. Well, we can walk if you want to. We were walking. These men pull up beside us and they scream out the window. They're trying to talk to her. She gets in the car with them. And so we're running like, bro, what are you doing? What are you doing? We're in the car. Now we're in the car with her. Now we're in the car with her.
Good friends.
Because what was I going to go back to? Like, I was going to stand right here in the middle of nowhere and call an Uber? Like, at that point, and it was cold too. It was not cold. It was kind of summertime. And so we get in the car. I'm like, bro, we're all like looking at her like, why did you get in this car? She's like, he said, like, I was like, no, bitch. Why are you getting this man's car? Like, we don't know this man. Yeah. What are you doing? So we're in the car. This man drives us. We don't know where this man drives us to. He drives us to his studio. That's his mama's house.
Oh. Run in the studio to drop some beats.
That's his mama's house. So I'm just sitting here looking around like, and she just over here just like, wow, what's this? What's that? I'm like, girl, he ain't no damn rapper. This nigga can't rap. What's wrong with you? This nigga can't rap. He over here like, yeah, that shit, like, that sound good. I like that.
Oh,
stop.
No.
Stop. Because he's not even good. Cute. Stop.
Oh, I was going to say.
Y'all not even get cute. The real studio experience.
No, because it's his mama house. He called his mama at that time. I said, listen to this. She can sing. Because he was talking about me. Ooh. I was singing something under my breath. I guess he called me. And I was like, I'm not singing for you. And then he's like, oh, my mama can come. I'm like, not your mama. Not why your free? Mama here?
No.
Why God. Your mama here? So we sat there. Honestly, for until like 5 a.m. because she didn't want to leave. And we got forced to listen to this man's music. And he was like, oh, you got your own radio show? And I was like, yeah. At the time, I did. Shout out to WSTU. I was like, yeah, I guess I can. I was lying. I wasn't going to put myself on the radio because it was horrible.
Terrible.
And then it wasn't clean. Why are you giving me explicit ass music to put on a student station?
Never.
Are you slow? Well, so, I mean, yeah. No, because you know better. you know better.
Fine, I probably would have lied. I ain't gonna lie.
I lied. But we didn't get back home until like 8 in the morning, 9 in the morning, all because we got in somebody's car we didn't know.
The next day?
They took us to Waffle House and they paid for everything though.
Wow. See, I was there all night.
Listening to this man music, that's torture. Ooh. That's risky. Because I would have, no.
That's risky and torture.
I'm glad you said it. I'm glad you made it through.
Why am I sitting in your house? Like, this ain't even your house. Uh-uh.
Wow. House.
The mama house.
What y'all got?
I'm gonna go the safe route. I ain't gonna go too crazy. All jokes aside, though, I would say the riskiest thing that I ever did was actually moving back to Atlanta. Only because I had just graduated college in 2013 and had built myself up to be a DJ back in Boston in Massachusetts, right? And before I left, I was known as like a basketball player. So I went, came back as a DJ, and people were like, what the fuck? You know what I mean? And I had to get used to everybody, like kind of, like I was away, and not that I didn't come back to school and back home and stuff, but like people were already partying in the midst of things. So I had to like weed my way through the city and make a name for myself. And I feel like I moved from Boston like in the middle of my prime. And like, I don't only feel like that. A lot of people have came up to me and said, yo, like, why did you move right then and there? You were like hot. I had a radio station. I could pretty, like, I was DJing a lot. But I just knew that if I moved back, I was going to challenge myself. Like, I love Boston to death, and I felt like I kind of did what I needed to do out there. So I felt like it was my time to kind of come out here and do what I need to do. And It was risky, trust me, because I came out here and I was getting hit with gigs like every day. And that's like super depressing to not know nobody out here for real, for real. Mm-hmm. And you getting, you know what I'm saying, people hitting you up damn near every other day for some gigs and some money. So like, right. It was really, really risky to do that. But it was like, either I'm going to do it now or I'm going to get stuck here. Mm-hmm. And I didn't want to do it later, because if I would have waited, because that was in 2017. If I would have waited any later, you got COVID that hit. And mm-hmm. then I would have never made it back out here, you feel me? So
right,
it was it divine timing. So like, all jokes aside, moving back out here,
had y'all back.
Yo, moving back out here, I just trusted my gut, and I had to be comfortable with knowing that I was gonna be uncomfortable. And like, I'm still uncomfortable, you know what I'm saying? But it's a good comfort in a sense that I know that it's growth. If that makes sense. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I find solitude in that. And when things get hard, that's just kind of what I ease my mind back on. So that's why that was shit was risky. You know what
I mean? So, no, yeah. I love that.
Yeah.
We're glad you're here too.
Yes, glad you're here. Thank
you. You know.
You made it to us.
Yes, man. You know
what about you?
All right. So for me, this is only... Well, it's kind of funny. So when I first got my car, like, I was road running, honestly. And one time I just went down the street. I went down the road. This tire just came out of nowhere.
Oh, no.
And like, busted my side. Okay. That's just like the backstory of my riskiest moment. Is that the next month it's like South by, and I'm like, I'm about to go, y'all. I just got my car. I'm about to ride. He said it's just the front bumper. Like, everything's cool. I'm going. And I went by myself for 12 hours, drove all the way to Austin, Texas. I was just on the phone with my friend, like,
yo,
I just drove to Texas. I told them somebody was coming with me, but nobody is coming with me. I'm like literally down by myself with a busted vehicle.
And you did it.
And then the craziest part is that I went to like stop at like a rest stop or whatever. And somebody just knocks on my window. I'm like trying to take a nap. They knock on my window like, can you help me with something? I'm like, no, bro. I had to leave. Like, I had to leave.
Yes. Get the hell out of there.
Yeah. And to make this way worse, I didn't really have a place to stay. I just knew my homies were going to be there. So I like stayed with them. And luckily I had like a nice bed I could stay in, but it was wild.
That's risky business, bro.
It was wild. It was wild, but it was such a great experience. I feel like I really saw how.
That's love.
You know, how to move when I needed to.
I'm glad.
It is like that.
You do.
Sometimes the risk is not taking the risk. You know what I'm saying?
No, like, for real.
Sometimes you just got to go for it and like leave it to God. Like sometimes you got to bump your head and figure it out as you go. That's not always good.
Trial and error.
Trial and error. You know, calculated a little bit. You know, she had a newer car. It wasn't like that.
It wasn't, you know.
They said the engine was fine. Right, you know? It was checked out.
Calculated risk, bro.
But those are usually either the best experiences or the worst experiences when you take that risk on yourself and when you just take a risk, period. Like, you know, the worst could have happened, but God willing, it didn't.
And the best happened, period.
And now you're here with us.
For real. That's the important part. You're here with us.
We're happy that everybody
bitches logging out. I'm taking blush straight to the face. She got me nodding out. Say I'm a headache, but he just got take a Tylenol.
We about to get into the next segment.
Here we go. Big dot. It's called Hot or Not.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Hot or Not. Y'all played this before, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's either hot or it's not. Real simple. All right. So we just talked about Insecure. So let's bring up Euphoria. Y'all watch that?
Hot.
Yes.
Hot.
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 Boiling.
hot, boiling sizzling. Hot. I love that show. I love that show. Did y'all watch it like from before, or like did y'all just now like have to binge watch it and catch up?
See, I watched over quarantine because when it originally came out, I was like, "Oh, this is some white people shit." Because like, I'm sorry, but like, just you got just Zendaya on there, okay? But this still kind of a white show because she white too. So this really ain't. I didn't think it was for me.
Got it.
So at first I didn't jump on it, and then over quarantine, I watched a lot of shows that I didn't think I would like, and I end up actually like liking the stories. So Euphoria was one of them that I definitely just caught on to during the quarantine, and of course when they stopped their filming for a while, so it gave me a chance to catch up with everything and really just watch it without all of the distractions. Like, I'm in the house every day, all day, might as well watch something that's, you know, interesting and can get my, you know, keep me engaged.
That's true. Kiana was here for from day one.
Oh, you were?
I was here for it. But period. I love Zendaya, and I love shows. Like, I feel what you're saying on, like, you know, when there's only one black girl, like, oh, here we go. But I love Zendaya, and I was like, okay, if it's the only black girl, then she's gonna be my favorite character.
Emmy Award winning. Let's put that in front of her name, period. Emmy Award winning.
Like, so I was on it from season one, and I definitely love the show, like the new season I watch and everything. But for me, like, it's just not a show that I'm like super into, like I was into Insecure, because I think, one, I don't know that life. Like, I don't know much about, not in that way, but like, I don't know much about like drug addiction and stuff like that. Yeah. So it's hard for me to like connect to it in that way. And also because it's just a lot, it's like so much happening all the time where it just be like, girl, I can't keep up, but I'm gonna keep watching it.
Yeah, it's a whirlwind. It can be. I feel like a reason that when I started watching it, I went to school with a lot of people who weren't from America, so they were just away from their parents. They did a lot of drugs. And most of the time when they were doing all these drugs, it was because like it was so normalized where they were from. Like smoking weed was normal. It wasn't like a legalized weed or do this, do that. Like, they just let people do drugs at their own expense. And they didn't treat like addiction like, oh, you do these drugs, you're a bad person. Like, they just let people, especially in like Europe, they do all types of drugs. They get to experiment. They have this type of freedom that most people in America don't have. So they kind of had to adjust to that because they thought like doing all these drugs were normal. So I just would see it at firsthand of seeing them just do the drugs. I would never do that stuff, but I would just see them do it and just be like,
I love that for you. I was doing it, honey.
I was smoking weed.
I didn't even do that.
Weed was the end all be all.
I didn't do no drugs till college. I was actually,
love that for you.
Candy, I didn't really smoke into heavy until college myself. I didn't, because I played sports. I was like really, like I said, I was like known for basketball. I played basketball.
Can't be doing all that.
And I just know I just had a different association with it at the time. So then once I kind of started drifting away from that, it's been a wrap ever since. You know, so, but I would say Euphoria is hot. I like Euphoria. I don't know. I like seeing the different perspectives. I know it's a lot going on. But I kind of, I guess maybe it's the Gemini in me. I don't know. It's little, I can kind of keep up with the chaos. And it's just interesting. Like having my own experience with like having to go to like NA meetings because I got a charge and it was a part of like my probation and things like that. So when I see those types of things, like that's how I'm able to connect to some to those things. So bringing it back to you, I can understand why, like, maybe it might be hard for someone to be like, what the hell is this? Like, you know what I mean? Because you've never, like, seen something like that before. And it's it is a lot. Like, Euphoria can be a lot. I don't know. I hope the right demographic is watching it and knowing what to take from it. That's my only thing about it. I won't go too deep into it.
And watch at your own discretion, because it can be very triggering to people who have dealt with sexual harassment, any type of domestic violence or any type of abusive anything, relationships, parental relationships. It can be very triggering. They do give warnings at the beginning.
But I think that's part of the reason why it's hot, though, you know?
But I know some people may watch it and,
yes.
Mental health is important, so don't want to have you.
No, definitely. And I feel like, and I do appreciate them putting those little blips out there about, you know, drug awareness or, you know, whatever other situations they may have, they'll definitely put hotlines and just making sure, you know, they have some balance in there. So shout out to Euphoria. I'm curious to see where the show's gonna go from there.
Mm. Nick, you watch Euphoria?
Yes. Okay, so I did binge it and period. I felt so emotionally invested to every single character. I love how it's shot. I love how they're all just so attractive and like trendy. Like, I love all of the characters, I'm not gonna lie. So I'm like really interested into the story. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't seen this new season yet. Mm-hmm. So I need to catch up, but the last season got me hooked.
You got time. You can still get me hooked.
I'm gonna binge it. Like, I'm gonna just binge it.
I don't know. You might want to hurry up because the timeline gonna be talking a lot after these next two episodes because it's about to get spicy. I don't even think you can use enough words.
Look, I have to watch Sundays tonight. Don't.
I like knowing the story. You don't have like you can't spoil the story for me. Like,
period. I don't know, but it's gonna get real. But yes, trust me. I don't want nobody to spoil it for you. But yes, enjoy it. Enjoy it. Okay. So Euphoria, unanimously is hot.
Yes.
Hot. All right. Speaking of hot, let's talk about the hot girl herself, Miss Megan and Shanzia. I hope I said her name right. I think I did.
Shanzia.
So it's technically Shanzia featuring Megan with their song Lick. Have y'all heard it? Oh, damn, we got a mic drop. Yeah.
It's a nah for me.
It's lukewarm for me. Lukewarm,
I'm going to just let y'all finish talking because I got.
It's like she's been sitting out all day, but she's still not cold. Like she's not hot. But she's not cold. She's kind of like room temp.
I like that. I'm not mad at that because I could put it there because it's not terrible. Yeah. But damn.
You know, I might need to hear a DJ drop it. You know,
I'm be honest, y'all.
As I need to hear it at the party.
It's hard. So
I don't like the beat.
Mm. I don't like the beat. Only because like it's very Americanized. Like
it is.
When I saw that, I thought we was about to get some boop boop boop. Some rhythm, with some
Houston flavor on it, you know.
Right. Maybe Elephant Man on the remix type vibes. I was looking, maybe even Sean Paul. I was looking for one of those, right?
Yeah.
But y'all know what this record was. This record was like, she should have, and definitely I agree, it should have gave that. But y'all know this record was for the merging of two audiences. So do y'all really think that Megan's audience would have been like, super here for
they like to throw ass. They like to throw ass.
They want to throw ass.
They gonna want to dance and throw ass. Caribbean music is the best music to throw your ass to.
Only because I think Shorty Bop is bi, if I'm not mistaken. And even if she wasn't, because I know she's Jamaican, all that, how that goes. But either way, you know how that goes. Yeah. But regardless, either way, I think Megan's audience likes a good time. Right, and if you present it in a cute package way, and we can twerk to Megan's verse and shake our ass, and the next song could potentially be Essence or whatever the case may be, I feel like they could have really did something with that. So that's the only reason why I agree with you is lukewarm, but it's like, damn, like I was really just hoping for just some more rhythm. That's all. I just wanted some more rhythm. I think Megan delivered. You know what I'm saying?
She did.
I do think that she delivered, so I'm not going to take away from that. But I just think that maybe they got the wrong producer for this track and they did try to maybe go too commercial or try to do the American, they thought about it too hard. Like they thought about it too hard. American. And they just gotta
very
create.
Trendy.
They're just creating.
I got three things.
What you got? Late. What you got, Mimi?
Number one, cause one thing about Listener Bell, I tell the truth. You may not like it, but I tell the truth. 0 out of 10 stars. Beautiful gowns. Wow. Beautiful gowns. Beautiful gowns. Beautiful gowns.
Not one.
They
star?
Were beautiful. They I were beautiful. Have. They didn't have on no gowns, because, the song. But they were beautiful. Meg, she did what Meg do. She get on the track, and she put her little Houston bop, 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 she put all that into it. And it's just like, I expected really more from Shanzia, because it's her song.
Yes.
Yo, I always say this is a rule. You should never have your feature outdo you on your own song.
And she raps.
Stop you right there.
No, no. Raps. But as a yeah, person,
that's the whole point.
That's the whole point. You better, if I grab you, you better wash my ass.
Think about a monster. It's Nikki true. Nikki had to come on that, and that's that was true.
But what I would say is that as a person, when you have features, all I'm saying is that make sure you bring your A game, because it will be very noticeable when you're just doing the bare minimum and you just la, 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 like, okay, cool, you doing what you normally do, like you're doing effortless
that.
Shit.
I get
okay,
that.
But you let this person outdo you on your song. Now it's their song.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, this was your song. You got to take some type of ownership of your song, even if it is a feature.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Yes, I don't think she took enough ownership of her song and of her sound, because we like Shantia for the Caribbean sound.
Yeah.
She could have been doing what she always been doing and put Meg on it. Fine, cool. But I feel like she let Meg take over the song. I don't have no problem with it, but it's your song. Mm. I didn't even know it was her song until y'all said so.
Got it. So that so that's so, and like maybe that was the point of grabbing Megan, but I don't know. I just feel like sonically there was just a disconnect there overall.
Very much so.
And you know, we love them. You know, if you listen to this podcast, you know damn well we ride for Megan all day, every day.
I'm a hot girl.
And you know, we're definitely hoping for the best. But sometimes if it ain't it, it ain't it. You know, we gotta call a spade, so
Yes.
We are going to say that it's not a lick.
It's
right?
not a lick right now.
It's not a lick.
We're probably licking later.
The tongue ain't even out.
Come circle the block, boo-boo. Come circle the block
later.
Next time.
That's a later dream. We'll probably feel it in the summer, maybe.
Oh, beautiful gowns. That's what I'm going to say again. Beautiful gowns.
Okay.
Yeah. Spring, summer.
let's do our last. Let's do one more music. So, Ain't Humpin'. Manello,
we ain't nothing.
I'm gonna say NA.
I like her.
Ooh, I want to play for you right now, Nika.
Okay.
What?
We can't.
Y'all like it?
I think it's a fun record. I think it's a fun record.
I like
record.
How she raps. Like, she be sometimes.
That's what I was saying. I like how she raps, but I feel like I forgot what's the other popular
song. I don't
think
she's found her sound yet.
Oh, yeah, we ain't humping.
Yeah, this, I don't know. I don't know yet. I feel like it was something that has to grow on me.
Okay.
Like, the more I listen to it, but I do like her sound and everything like that. But the song specifically, I don't know, because, yeah.
Okay, so Mimi don't know. She on the fence.
It's hot.
What about you?
Kiana said it's hot, and that's period. Okay. But I love Monaleo, like, even from her very first single, like, literally eat. She has this song with Money Long, who did the Hours and Hours song. It's called Ballhead Bitch. Like, she has so many. I just love how she gets on a beat and she just ride that hoe. Like, she honestly reminds me of early Megan, of her hunger.
So Tina Snow.
Like, she gets on a track and she makes that track her track, and she knows exactly how to ride that beat. But in a way that reminds you that she's from Houston.
I was about to say she's from Texas. Mm-hmm.
Like she eats. Like,
she said she was having fun with it. She said she just kind of went in the booth and freestyled it. So I don't think it was something that she put a lot of thought into. I think I like the video.
I'll check it out.
I feel like every artist has a song where they really don't put no effort into it for real, and they just make something
of it now.
That's the only problem. It's too much. But the artists that do it, that are, like, you know, I won't say actually talented, but you know, they kind of got a little bit more oomph.
Yeah.
It can be a hit, you know.
Oh yeah, for sure. Well, I don't know. So what we saying? It's not.
It's hot to me.
We got a hot.
He got like. I'm not in the mood.
She's a media. We got to listen. Everybody has to listen. So
I'm not in the mood. I guess I'm not in that
specific
mood.
Play a little bit, and then I will be like the tiebreaker.
I feel like I gotta be in the mood for something like that. That's my thing. I'm not always in
They're
that type of mood.
Us, y'all, for the next season. They headed a game.
I wonder if I should make you watch this video or just listen to it. What you wanna do?
Just give me a little snippet. What's the best part?
Put that dick up, we not humping. Sky zone beach, my block jumping. Jump out the black truck, we start dumping. In the field with 100 bands, no
well, then.
I don't know. What? No.
that's nothing against her because I think now she's fire.
The video.
But
now watch the video. See, this is why I think visuals make a difference. Oh, is it going to pull up? I saw the video first. I was like, oh, this is cute, I guess. I'm not bumping it. I'm being honest. I ain't running around bumping it. So I can't say. I don't know. But all right, so we just going okay. to let
my
it
mouth
be.
Is open. I don't know.
We're going to let her marinate.
We're going to let her. We're going to circle the block on that one. Come back for 2.0. Oh, oh, oh.
No, for real. Come back for the 2.0.
Oh,
oh. Oh, but the thing is, this is the thing. This is the thing. Okay, Nika here. Nika here. This is the thing.
Yo.
All the girls are just taken from each other. I think she's trying to come off like Flo Millie, try to come off with the super hard, you know. Hey, I'm coming hard, but no, I don't know.
What you mean, like new Flo Millie trying to be hard?
No, like just how she opened up the song. Like we supposed to be like yes, so, like,
we not up to that type of thing.
Yeah. We supposed to be like, oh, you came hard, girl,
but that's how
she lost me
be.
As soon as like. She lost me.
I think she was. I mean, listen, if that's what you think, that's what you think. Fuck it, right? But I just think that she was just trying to have fun.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's what it sounded like. It's just, I'm shocked by what she was saying. Like,
and the girls have to be like that. Like, literally, my generation. If it's not at the first 30 seconds, it's got to go. Like, wow, I'm turning it off. So it has to grab my attention. And I feel like in that same vein of, like, a Flo Millie, that's how Flo Millie really, like, people started getting on her. Was like, damn, like, what's she saying? Like, dicks up when I step in a party. Like, period.
Also with her tag. She said Flo Millie shit. Ho. Yeah. Like, who is she talking about?
So you got to come on the beat and say, put that dick up. We not humping. Like,
I just think that, like, when I hear the beat, I don't think of those words going with that beat. That's just the problem. Because I hear that beat, I'm thinking, like, oh, they about to come in with something just, like, just, She said, put that dick up, we not humping. I said, huh? What?
Now, this is
That's what you about to talk about on this
and
beat?
She said it, like, so
because the beat just sounds so and fast like, and, like, very, like, aggressive and punching. And then she's just over here just chilling. Like, girl, this ain't the beach.
I like it.
Get to the mic. Get close to the mic. Sit up.
Okay,
sit up.
Cool. I'm glad we could check that out.
Yeah, no.
unfortunately, we it's a knot.
It's a knot.
It is a knot.
I want to say it's one hot.
It is one hot, but overall, it is a knot.
But I want the girls to know, you know, there's somebody championing for you.
You know, it's okay.
We still root for you, sis.
We love you.
We got you on the next one.
And we want you to beat down the block again.
Yes, beat down that block again and again. Yeah.
We still stream your old stuff, sis.
Keep finding your sound. That's okay, boo boo.
You're an artist. You're supposed to experiment.
Exactly.
Yes. Yeah.
All right. I'm going to be honest. I don't know if I know how to say this show name right, Nika. So you got to say it.
Abbott Elementary?
Yep, because I was totally finna say it the different way. So I'm happy you said it.
Oh, my God. Ooh,
not, I wasn't going to fuck it up that bad, y'all. I'm not
That's
slow.
How you made it sound, though. You made it sound like you were going to mess it
but
up.
But I messed
hot
up
or not.
Already. Oh, okay.
That's not my strong
Y'all been watching it?
Hot.
I haven't watched it yet. I don't know why I'm slow to watch it, and I want to, and I see everybody talking about it, and it's funny, and I'm a goofy person. I just haven't watched it yet. I don't know. I'm going to click it one day and watch it.
Yeah.
I'm going to be mad if I ain't laughing, y'all.
The principal is funny.
It is so funny.
The principal is hilarious, bro. Like
every character is, like, super hilarious. Shirley Ralph is on there. She's the bomb. Like,
not Moesha Mo.
I'm 30. For real. Okay. She's deep for real, but she, like.
I know her as the dream girl.
Oh
yeah, I'm dead.
Dream girl, yeah.
I love Abbott Elementary. I think that at first I wasn't really here for it. Like it definitely is a show that I just binged like less than 5 days ago, type of thing. So I'm
how many episodes?
It's like 4, I think.
Yeah, it's been out for like a month.
It's bingeable in a day. I'll say in like an evening. And so when I watched it, I was like, you know, I don't know if this is gonna give because one thing about Kiana was not here for The Office. I don't care. You can fight your mother, your grandmother, and your auntie about it. I was not here for it. Like so, when I saw Abbott Elementary, I was like, But I love the main character. Her name is escaping me right now. But
Quinta Brunson, I love her. I have watched her like from when she was on YouTube.
We love
like,
the trajectory for sure.
She's always been funny to me. So I was like, okay, I'm going to give it a chance just for her. And I love it.
She wrote it too, which is, I think,
yeah,
is
she
dope.
Wrote it. Yes.
She wrote it. And honestly, I just love Quinta because, like Kiana said, like, I've been watching her for so long. Just, like, she's so funny, very organically. She's, you know, it's very rare to find someone who's organically funny. And then the fact that she wrote it, you can tell, you can tell that, like, okay, yeah, like, she has some great comedic timing because most of their lines, what they say, like, them looking into the camera type shit, that's just hilarious. I love it. And the principal, she's a black Michael Scott. If you watch The Office, she's a black Michael Scott. This woman will do anything illegal so to save her job in whatever company she thinks she running. Like, girl, this is a school. You just took somebody's job because you blackmailed a pastor? Really? Really? Yeah,
she is not principaling correctly, but it's funny.
Yeah, but it works, though, I guess.
And who better to, like, have a stare in the camera moment than the Everybody Hates Chris himself?
Who,
like,
always staring into that damn camera. Like,
the casting, I feel like that's really what makes the show so funny. Is that the casting, everybody on that cast fits the role that they are given.
It is
like,
perfect casting. It really is.
I love that show.
I just love seeing him act again and seeing him act outside of like what we know him as. Right. Especially as an adult, because as an adult, I know people didn't take his adult, like, you know, parts he played like seriously. Mm-hmm. And I get why, but it's like, you know, he's growing out of that, and I'm glad, because I hate when child actors are like stuck or have to stuck. And when they're grown as hell too, like, they're like 30 and you're still trying to put them in this child ass role. Like, they're too big for this. Like, let them grow up. I like that we're letting him grow up.
That's dope. Yes. That's true. That makes points. And everybody, I do see everybody kind of complimenting him and enjoying his presence in the show. And everything y'all are saying is definitely things that, you know, we're hearing and I've been seeing. So the show's hot. And I need to watch it.
Dude.
Yes.
It is hot.
It's a nice it's little hot. If you want to laugh it's and you hot. Just at home. That's what
I
it's for.
I always want to laugh. So I'm definitely going to definitely take my time and watch that.
Kick your
that.
Feet up and watch that, girl.
So we got that. I like that. Okay. Yeah. But Queens. Y'all, Queens. Hot. Hot.
Hot.
Hot.
I'm say that medium. Can I say medium?
You can say lukewarm. Lukewarm to be the the midpoint.
No, because I like the lukewarm
okay,
midpoint.
This is Nika because, like, I was really rooting for Queens. Really, I was like telling us we gotta watch it, y'all. We gotta watch it. It's dropping this day. We gotta watch it. But as soon as it came on, it just lost me. Like, it really lost me. And then now Eve is like gone. For some reason, she don't know if she's coming back. I've been reading articles.
Oh, Lord.
Like, I don't know. So now I'm not entertained anymore.
Let me see. You know, Eve be ready for peace and going and being with her little rich
and
hubby,
she's faking her death right now? Is that what happened?
Hold on. Oh, wow.
I read articles. I'm sorry. I didn't even watch the show.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. I have not watched that show. Only because I don't know. Not that it didn't grasp me, because it's like a lot of my favorite people. Like, I grew up and love Brandy. I love Eve. Like, don't ever get it twisted. But I don't know. I have to wait to kind of see before I get invested in things. Cause I am going to be mad if I watch that show and I don't like it, because it is all of my favorite people. Does that make sense?
Exactly.
So you don't want to be disappointed.
Yeah. So
and it's understandable.
So I kind of haven't watched it yet. Cause it's if I see enough good things about it, then I'm like, okay, I'll go back and you know, binge it and watch it. But if I don't see enough good things, then I just won't watch it at all. Cause
that makes sense.
I think you should
though.
Watch it, but I think that you should watch it. You should watch it with the idea and the fact that it's an ABC show in your mind. It's not going to give you BET. It's not going to give you
HBO. VH1. It'll give you Fox.
It's not going to dive into the culture
not no
like
stars.
That.
It ain't going to give you Fox or no HBO.
It's not produced by 50 Cent.
To put it in perspective, the very first time we hear Brandy sing on the show, I think it's like a Taylor Swift song or something.
Oh,
like,
wow. Okay,
that's
got
what
it.
They got Brandy singing
got
the first time
it.
We hear her sing. So it's like... Figured. For me, I like it, and I say that it's hot because with that in mind, I wasn't going into it with the expectation that it was going to give me that really just based off the promo single that they dropped. I was like, okay, yeah, this is supposed to be like,
yeah, the music is dope, you know, in there.
Almost corny, but not.
See, like, we so that was it. The yeah. thing. Yeah. I'm yeah. like, I yeah. it, I was like, it look a little.
But it is good. It gets good. Like, at first, it's kind of like, okay, girl, like, this is just predictable. Okay, but I tell you one thing that happens. Good.
I don't care.
Eve has like a hookup with Fabio Foreign.
Mm-hmm. That's random as hell.
And she's like somebody. Very. She got a mom of five kids. Her husband literally just died.
Okay,
his funeral was like not even a week ago.
But then he also lied to her though.
His side chick is pregnant. So it's a lot going on for her. But it's like Fabio Foreign of all people.
Her face.
And he tells the radio show, like, yeah, I just hooked up with her. Her son, like, Mom.
This is real messy.
Mom, that was a lot.
Okay. Her whole, like, story aspect, when I first watched it, it was just messy from the jump. Yeah, I think her husband was a trifling-ass Negro. Yes, he was. Trifling-ass Negro.
They doing my girl wrong.
Because how dare you?
Wow, okay. Yeah.
It's good, though.
So, Candy here. Clearly, I'm the only person who has not watched it. But I have been given all the reasons to watch it. So
you
it's
should
hot.
Watch it, though.
You said it's lukewarm. You said it's hot.
What so, it's mostly got? Hot. It's mostly
I
hot.
I would say that it is lukewarm because I only saw the first two episodes okay, so far. Okay, I haven't okay. caught up yet. I haven't got it's a chance cold. To catch all the way up.
So, no, it ain't cold. That equals out to hot. You got okay. lukewarm, and hot. It's yeah, just Kiana a little on the hot. Hotter side, you know. Okay, it's like okay, right it's before still. It gets boiling hot. You
it's
know
warm.
What I mean?
Yeah. It's warm. Yeah. It's warm.
I got to okay. watch the it's rest warm. Of them to really see how I feel because I watched the first two just to kind of get a tester.
Oh, so you ain't even really in it, really.
Well, the thing is, when I was trying to catch up with it, because I would watch it when it premiered on Hulu, like just like watch it as is, and you know if you miss it, you know I'm just like okay, it'll be back there later, and I did that for like the next 3 weeks, and I just forgot
until
about it.
Get into the thick of it.
But like, I get so busy real, though, yeah. like it's so hard for me to watch TV.
Yeah.
So because like throughout the week, I really don't watch TV yeah. unless I really have nothing to do. So getting me to watch something is. It, trust me, I have a short attention span too. So getting me to watch something is—it's a task. It's yeah. a sport. So yeah,
you're saying everything I like. I could watch your lips move all night, making me think you might have the type of brain I like. Promise I'ma make it rain for you, something like an ocean wave on you. If you let me open up to you, kiss below the line. I wanna see what your head game like. Do you know what you're doing? Is your neck game tight? Do you know how to use it? Have a long conversation with me. I talk back, baby, we can get deep. I wanna see what your head game like. Do you know what you're doing?
Aye,
is your
neck game tight? Listen to Bell here. We're back with a segment, Fuck, Marry, Heal. We lay praying hands. We do not kill.
Period.
Okay.
Period.
All right. So we're going to go ahead and just get started with the first person. We have Woody McClain from Power Book 2 and also his infamous role of playing Bobby Brown. What y'all think?
Okay.
And then we have Algie Smith from Euphoria and New Edition. Mm-hmm. And then we have Tyler James Williams from Everybody Hates Chris and popular new show Abbott Elementary. What y'all think?
I'm gonna let y'all go first.
Well, you know, if we gotta get into it, so I'm gonna go ahead and just, you know, I gotta see what Tyler James Williams is giving. Like, I'm gonna have to, you know, drop the draws for him because yeah. I feel like he's a very fine man. You know, he's definitely grown into himself outside of being Chris. Like, he's grown now. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know. It's something it's about him that, like,
He's mature. He's grown into the body.
It's the body. Yeah, because he has the body, you know.
Yeah. The facial hair. I got to see what that body is giving.
The voice. The voice is what's really good, too.
Oh,
you know?
Yes, the voice.
The voice, girl.
Yes. So I got to drop the draws for him. And I'm going to marry Woody. Because Woody is the tallest, according to Google.
Okay, smart.
He's the tallest out of the bunch, so I'm going to have to date him. I'm going to have to marry him. And then on top
How
of that.
How tall is he?
The streets saying he's 6'2".
They say he's 6'2".
I don't know.
He don't look like it, though. When he was playing at Bobby Brown, he looked like he was Bobby Brown height.
5'10".
I'm going to go with it. And on power, as Kane, that's a man. That's a man. And he could get it.
I can agree.
He could get it.
And then I'm gonna have to lay the hands on Algie Smith. I'm gonna need the Lord to lay his hands on him to bless him with some growth serum, some extra inches, or you know, some more feet. Whatever the Lord can do for him. Right. But as a 5'5" man, I just can't.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna pray for you, my He's brother, not my five, king. Five.
That's look
what
it
the
up.
Streets are saying. That's what
look
the streets
it up.
Saying.
Nah,
he looks little though. If you look at pictures of him, he looks small. Like he looks like a
he looks
he like a little boy.
Small, but he don't look short. Mm. 5'5"? He's only 5 more inches taller than me.
That's true, because I am 5'2". That's three inches.
What the streets say.
I'm 5'7", so what I'm gonna do with that?
Okay.
You are tall.
You're gonna heal him with your hands.
Yes.
That's right.
You are tall.
Yeah.
I love you, King.
Okay. What you got, Mimi? What you think?
All right. So I'ma go ahead. I would marry Tyler James. Well, he just seems like very dependable. It seems like he could be a great husband.
I love that.
That is
seems like he could be a great husband. Okay. I feel like it's just like, you know, I feel like with his attitude and his personality, I don't think you would see him in too many scandals of cheating on people and shit like that.
So, he seems
you know,
loyal.
Yeah, he's, you know. And then I would say for a heel, it definitely got to be Algie Smith. I honestly just because like, I don't know, like, this is his part on Euphoria. It's just a huge turnoff because why are you this college-ass Negro worried about these high school children? Why are you worried about these kids? You're not here no more.
Honestly. You're trying to catch a
yeah,
case,
no,
bro.
See, when you play parts like that, it's a turnoff. You're giving Predator. You know,
His character is giving
Predator. And now, not like, him. I can't dissociate your face from that character because you still playing him.
Okay,
know?
So I have a serious question. No. I'm not about to. I have okay. I have a serious question. So, are in high school? Are they seniors? This group of kids?
They're 17.
Okay,
it's like a range.
So in certain states, 17 is an adult. I just want y'all to know that. Just, I'm not defending him. I just
he's
want
not
to
a
be
predator
known.
For real.
He's
not
he's a
predator.
Freshman and he's a senior. I just want to be, because I see, I'm like, we got to be careful with that. If she was short, it was like a freshman.
Well,
then
I'm only
maybe.
Saying because, like,
but they're like, they went to high school together and then he graduated and went, right? I'm not tripping.
No. I get it. I just think that, like, when you're in college and you're worried about high school,
now that
business,
is different.
It gives predator.
Yes.
Because that's what I said predator towards. It's you're worried about high schoolers in college. You know, you should worry about other things.
Well, yes, of course.
You know, playing a character like that.
Right,
okay, no, I'm like, wait, am I wrong for the way that I'm thinking?
No,
I'm
no,
like,
no, no,
wait,
no.
Okay,
no, no,
no.
It's his thought process
to,
and where he, and where he.
I get what
him.
You're saying.
Yeah.
No, that's no. He's dead. Like you're in college. You don't want to go chase the other girls in college.
Not even
right,
that, but
right?
You don't want to do your homework.
Well, that
or worry about your major.
You don't go to practice.
There's no frat parties.
Okay,
you know, yeah. So that's why I think his character just turns me off completely.
Got it. Yeah.
And I would and I would fuck Woody McClain only just to say that I did so, because I think he's a very attractive person. I just don't think he's marriage material. That's that's
in real life.
No, yeah, I'm the same as you. Those are all mine.
Yeah.
Really? But I would say Tyler James Williams, because I feel like he would just have great conversation.
Yeah. Like, yeah, he most definitely would. And wouldn't you want to marry someone that you can talk to for real?
Yeah, like,
yeah.
Like
yeah.
He probably would crack me up all day long. So, I'm really
into
that.
What would you
that.
Talk to him about?
Probably like books and how Chris Rock was back in the day. I'm or dead. Like,
I know he talked about talking about that. He don't want
to
hear that.
Stories to tell, you know. Probably read a lot.
Okay,
that's what I'm thinking.
I see. I'm gonna heal both Algie and Tyler.
You can't heal them both.
Yes, I can, because I'm not marrying neither one of them or fucking neither one of them. So they're each gonna get one of my hands.
I didn't know you could do that.
No.
Is that how the rules go? I didn't know you could do that.
I don't know, but I'm breaking
you
the rules.
You can heal
right
two
now.
People? Wow.
No, I'm only saying one person. That I cannot, for some reason, I cannot look at Tyler like that. That's how I feel, like how y'all just felt about that, that's how I feel, little brother. So like no,
that's what he is.
So like no, so I can't. And then Algie, he just looks soft. Like I like soft, don't get it twisted, but like he just curly like hair. Y'all, and then y'all just said he was 5'5". Like, so then now I'm just like, you already look like I'm gonna be cuddling a remote. So like and then like
not the remote.
Yo, a short remote at that now.
You mean that old Comcast remote?
So like, you know, I'm gonna heal the both of them. And then I'm gonna fuck Woody.
As you should.
Then leave him dry.
You're not marrying nobody.
Period. Not out that much.
Period.
Can't do it.
Okay. Well, as you should.
That's fair. That's fair. Yeah. What about the next bunch, Mimi? Who else we got?
Ooh. Okay. So up next we have Method Man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, y'all know how he look. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yum. Yes. We have Nas and we have Common. Mm-hmm. All right. So, I'm going to let you go first, Kiana.
Ciao. Off top, either Method Man getting fucked or married. And that's period.
No, that's so period.
I would have to say that I'm going to marry Method Man just off the fact that you ain't fucking nobody else. Like, once I get that man, it's over with. Like, Method Man is so fine to me. I can't. Yum. So, I'm going to have to marry him just off of that fact. But that means I got to fuck. Now, Nas, I love Nas. Nas is my favorite rapper, my favorite male rapper. So I feel like it's weird to like fuck Nas. Like, I never looked at Nas like, I want to fuck. Like, but I guess I'll fuck Nas.
You got some aunties listening to this podcast, like, right? Like, girl.
No, for real. Not even Nas, like, girl.
Young Nas was fine. But
definitely was an attractive ass man.
Current
yes,
Nas,
man.
Like 40 something year old Nas, I just could no, not. Really? It just doesn't give like coochie.
He literally
you
looks
know?
The same.
It gives like, oh, let's pray together. But I don't want to heal him. I want to heal Common, just because something about Common just you know, like something about
you.
Him.
I'm with
just,
you.
It don't
some
make
off.
Sense.
Some
it's certain
off.
Men where it's like, it don't make sense. It's no reason. You know, like, it's just something about you that just don't.
You ain't got nobody. Ain't nobody wants you, and you look like that.
It just don't.
Don't play with me. Don't lie in my face. Nobody wants you, and you look like that. It's a problem.
Yeah, he gonna have to get
it's an
healed.
Issue.
He gonna have to get healed, but it's okay.
Yeah.
No. He's okay. With Tiffany Haddish right now.
Really?
They're like a whole couple.
Oh, that's a couple. Weird couple, but I'm here
they're
for
not
it.
Together no more, though.
They're not?
Really?
No. Mm-mm. That's what I'm saying. Like, it's something wrong with like. Him because how are you that, you know what I'm saying? Like, that seem they seem like a good relationship. And yeah.
So you know what Common might be? Common might be one of those dudes that might be a little too smart for his own good. And he might be like toxic smart on the low, and we don't know. Not for real.
No, I can see that. Probably. That's why I'm laughing. That's why I'm
like,
laughing. I
think because he's a smart man, and sometimes smart men are like, they're too smart for their own good.
You know what he gives me, though? What? Like, this, like, he's really woke. And I feel like that gets annoying. Yeah. Especially to someone like Tiffany Haddish, who, like, you know, she cracks her jokes. She says all types of shit. He's kind of like, well, he dated Erykah Badu. Come on, y'all. We know how Erykah Badu to being.
That's why he came.
So, you know, Erykah Badu has this, you know, she's a great person. And she inspires people to, like, be very spiritual. And sometimes, you know, sometimes people don't want to hear all that. And so when you date someone, they don't want to hear all that. Especially when it becomes very unrealistic. Hmm. Especially someone like Tiffany, how she'd be like, nigga, what the fuck you talking about? Like, and she probably has said that to the nigga because he used to be talking about crazy ass shit. Like, what are you doing? Like, just doing random shit.
I don't know because I do also feel like something about Tiffany Haddish gives me that, like, she's way smarter than she lets off.
Oh, very much
like,
so.
She seems
very
not
much
saying
so.
That she may be on Common's level, because I do definitely think that Common and Erykah Badu definitely share that, like you said, DJ Candy Rain, like that they're too smart.
Mm-hmm.
And to the point where it's almost like, are you smart or are you dumb? But we love you.
Because now you're doing too much thinking.
But we love you. You're doing a lot.
Yeah.
You know,
you're
but
overthinking
I feel like Tiffany has that
smartness in her where she probably keeps up with him.
She know what
but
she
he
doing.
Probably win in the end. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, of course. But I just feel like she's probably tired of that, because why am I having a mental battle with you every time I sit down to talk with you? Because you so smart and you want to be extra super woke every time we talk about something. Like, shut up. Right. Let's just talk about regular shit.
So what you got?
What you got, Nick?
Okay, yeah, I'm definitely healing common.
Yeah.
We could just say that's a consensus.
No, we're healing him. We're healing him.
I'm healing common.
It's the, yeah, he's just getting healed. And definitely fucking Method Man.
As you should.
Just because that's a fantasy. And I'm marrying Nas because I feel like he's going to put me on to something.
That money.
I'm going to be about, I'm probably be billionaire gang with him. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. We'll definitely get married. Okay. He probably is a billionaire and ain't just telling nobody or something.
He's invested like, in a lot of things.
Our billionaire pending.
Some Bitcoin things and all that.
He invests his money.
He definitely does.
Maybe. So I'm totally healing common.
Period.
All the hands on deck for my man.
Yep.
I am going to marry Method Man because we see how he moves as a married man already. And I'm just going to assume that's just him as a character and just how he really, when I say character, like him, his as a man, like, you know what I'm saying? That's how he moves. So I like that. He's fine. He's handsome. He take care of himself. Yes. Mm. Give me Method Man. Mm. And then I'm going to smash Nas and then maybe, you know, smoke a blunt and talk about going to Africa after. And see what Nas is working with. Maybe he might get healed too. But if I had to choose, that's probably what I'm rolling with.
Period.
I love y'all's answers. I love this. So I'm a Mary Method Man.
Okay.
Just because, like, why not? And then we definitely gonna heal Kami. We already said that, child. I would fuck Nas only because I would say, for me personally, I don't think he's matched to a personality wise because I don't really know much about him. Okay. And I wouldn't feel right marrying somebody I don't know nothing about. Like, I don't know nothing about you as like a public figure, you know, I just know your music. You know, I don't want to be that person just marry you because I know your music. Sorry.
But you'll fuck him. Period.
I would fuck him because I feel like...
No shade. But
it's
like,
just a one and done thing. You know what I'm saying? It's not like a lifetime commitment. I'm not going to do a lifetime commitment with no stranger. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? No. Not no stranger.
Exactly.
I know Method Man. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I'm dead.
You know? Turned around. How she said that was funny as shit. Yo, I know can't Method wait Man. Till we get videos. This is funny.
Common Mr. Grand Rising.
He is
Mr. Biscuit.
Yeah, but we love you, but you're healed.
Oh my goodness. All right, well, that was great, y'all. So y'all play with us if you're listening. Let us know what you're gonna do. Who are you gonna fuck, marry, and heal? All hands on deck.
Yes. And we wanna leave y'all with a tip, a carefree key. You know, just something for you to take home as a carefree Black girl. I just want the people to know your path is your own. Like, the journey that you have is your own. We live in a culture, and I hate even saying that because it's always like, as a society. But honestly, like, with social media and with the digital space, we see people win all the time. We see there's so many people that you can compare yourself to, but none of those people are you. None of those people have the same purpose as you. None of those people were given the same circumstances, probably. So what you do on this earth literally is only your business and it's only your path. And you should not be comparing it to other people. And that's period, because this is your path. This is what you got, like your achievements, your purpose, you literally create the world that you are in. So if you're in your head like, oh, I need to be her, I need to be this, then you're just going to be constantly trying to be somebody else. And then at the end of the day, who are you, hun? You don't even know. Mm-hmm. Now you're 60 and just confused. Oh. And that doesn't give. So just tap into yourself, figure out what you want to do, follow your heart, follow your gut, your intuition, and just trust yourself. Period.
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 And that's that on that. And that's that on that.
Exactly.
A on my blog, Broke to Dope, on broketodope.com, on Instagram, and Broke to Dope on Twitter. That's with the number 2.
Ow, put your twos up. What's up, y'all? It's Candy Raine, and you can follow me across all platforms at My Candy Raine. Please come find me on Twitter. You know, if you used to follow me, I got a whole new joint because they done got me out of here, and I'm trying to find y'all. You know, definitely follow me on SoundCloud, and make sure you tune into my radio show, The Sweet Spot, every Tuesday and Wednesday, 3 to 5 p.m. on Spark FM Online.
Oh, hey everyone, it's the one and only the Lit Southern Belle, Mimi Navah, and you can follow me on Instagram at MIMINAVAH Mimi Navah. On Twitter is the same as well.
And you know the vibes, big dot. It's your girl, Rebellious Kiana. You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at Rebellious Kiana. That's Kiana, K-I-A-N-A. I don't know how the other girlies spell it, but that's how I spell it. So if you want to keep up with me, make sure you follow me. And make sure you are following Carefree Black Girl on all platforms. On Instagram, that's going to be Carefree Black Girl, Inc. So that's I-N-C. And then on Twitter, it's Carefree Black Girl Pod, but it's just the letters, hon. So it's C-F-B-G-P-O-D. One more time, CFBGPOD, and make sure that you're using the hashtag CarefreeBlackGirl so that you can keep up with us, keep up with the conversation, and we can see who y'all want to fuck, marry, and heal, period.
How? Ooh. Dot. Whatever y'all be saying.
And we out.
Bye.
Stepping on these bitches next like I'm a chiropractor. Everywhere I go, they call it Jake, say I'm a fire hazard. And I ain't talking about no snitches when I say I'm with the teller. I got all different kind of minks, but I need that spot like I'm Cruella. Just as South Beach for a quick trip. Big dreams to a little bitch. Pulled up in that foreign thing, but I'd rather nigga like...
I switched to Boost Mobile and got a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone. Want to know the best part?
It was free?
Nope.
The fact that it's on America's largest 5G networks?
Nope. It's the ding.
Oh yeah, love the ding.
Right? It's all about the ding. It's the dingarooski, the dingaroner, the ring-a-ding-ding.
Unleash your power to save with Boost. Get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone when you switch. Boost Mobile, unleash your power.
And the ding.
Limited time offer, new customers only. Available on select networks. 5G not available everywhere. One device per line, tax excluded. Additional restrictions apply. See your local Boost Mobile store for details.
Shop Amazon for last minute gifts. Great deals for everyone on your list. Gifts for mom and gifts for dad. Even for your sister and your brother, Chad. Ah, shoot, we didn't realize we were supposed to get a gift for our dog walker guy. We almost forgot about our dentist, Dr. Kerr. We didn't expect to get a gift from her. Or our cousin, I forget his name. He got us something nice. Better reciprocate. For last minute deals on gifts for people you forgot. Get faster free shipping at Amazon.